and welcome. Today I'm going to show you how to use this social media content planner in Google Sheets. If you want to get inspired and create your own planner, feel free to go ahead. If you prefer a ready-made product and save yourself from the hassle, this template is available for purchase in my store. I'll leave a link in the description below. So without further ado, let's get started. This template is actually an upgraded version of my previous content planner template that I created for year 2022. But this upgraded version is more dynamic, easily customizable, and user-friendly. The feature I like the most is that we are able to decide our holiday calendar based on our country selection, and we can add on specific days such as the event days using the event tracker. So these days will be pulled and displayed on our monthly calendar. So it really helps content creators to be able to plan ahead based on all the happenings. Another feature I improve on is the cleanliness of the template. I have realized that having too many tabs makes it difficult to navigate and focus, even though we have the link at the yearly calendar. Hence, I have decided to add this checkbox and allow you to generate a monthly content calendar for each month when you need it. To start using, you'll need to go to the settings page to customize your planner. At the top, we have a section to customize our calendars. So this includes the events or holiday calendars, the year at a glance, and a monthly calendar. So let's go back to the settings page and enter the calendar year, say 2024. Once we do that, you can already see the changes being reflected in the rest of the pages. Then we can select whether the calendar should start on Monday or Sunday. If we change it to Sunday, the start day of all the calendars will be customized based on that selection. For the event page, based on the year that we have just selected, we can see all the holiday dates in the country that we selected. So we can change our default country to other country using this dropdown. Currently, only a few countries are being supported. I'll continue to add more, but if your country is not included here, feel free to send me a message or leave a comment below so I can work on it for you. In the same page, say if you have other key dates to include in your monthly calendar, you may add them in this event tracker. You just have to key in the date by double-clicking this cell, add the event name, campaign type, and comment. Note that the day of week would be populated based on the date that you enter here. Then all these events will be added to your calendar. So I'm going to create one monthly page for September so that I could share with you that this actually works. So now you can see that the custom event that I just added in the tracker is displayed automatically in the September planner. If you're running a global business, you may want to include more than one country holiday calendar. Say if I want to include Canada, United States, and Malaysia. So what you can do is to select the first country from the menu, for instance, USA. Then we're going to copy and paste the table to the tracker section. When you copy, just copy from the column date to the comments. When you paste, remember to paste the values only because we don't want to carry the formatting of the previous table to the tracker. We're going to continue to do the same for Canada. Just select it from the drop-down and copy and paste it to the tracker. For the last country, which is Malaysia, we are going to select the country from the drop-down. And that's it. Now, if we go to the calendar, we can see all the events from all these three countries in September, and they're all included in this planner under the events section. So after we have set up the events, we can start using the content planner. First, we'll generate the content calendar for the months we need. If I need February, then this page will be generated after the click and you will be directed to the content calendar. Here you can see we have a mini calendar on the top left with a cute photo, a monthly goal section, events, notes, and a horizontal post section for every single day. This is generated based on the number of days we have in the month. For example, when I choose February, then I'm going to get 29 days for the year that I have selected. So make sure that you have set your calendar year and start day before you start to generate the monthly planner, just to make sure we have the right days. Under the same page, we have some other options that you can use to customize the planner. Unlike the calendar year that you will need to predefine before you generate the monthly planner, these options can be applied later on. But if you prefer to do it now, you can hover on the headers to see the comments that are written down there. But if you prefer a more detailed walkthrough, you can watch this video until the end. So let's move back to the February monthly calendar. At the left hand side, we can enter our monthly goals. I think it will be helpful to make sure your content is aligned with your business goals during the content planning process. As for the event section, as I mentioned previously, this will be based on the holiday calendars and the custom events that we have insert in the events tab. So if you have any new events to add on, you shouldn't really edit this part. Instead, you should go to events and add on into the events tracker. On the right hand side, we have a horizontal scrolling calendar. So this is designed for content creators to add a maximum of one content per day. We will start by adding the image for the static post or the video thumbnail if it is a video post. So to add an image, just click on this cell and go to insert and select image and then select image in cell. Then we are going to click browse and upload the image if it is in your computer. Otherwise, you may upload it from your Google Drive directly. Then we will fill up the content info section. Simply click on the drop down and select a value. You can also categorize the content by adding the metadata info such as the content pillars, subtopics, goals, the status, and live date. So tracking status of the content is really easy with this status drop down. There'll be a progress bar shown on top and just below the image so that you can visualize the progress easily. And as I change the status, you'll see the bar starts to move based on the percentage that I have set in the settings tab. So all these drop downs and selection that I've just shown you in this content info section are totally customizable. So later in this video, I'll show you how to do that. Moving on, we have a caption section. So here you can add your text in this box. If you want to type to the second row and have an empty row, we can use Command or Control Enter. So for Mac, it will be Command Enter. For Windows, it will be Control Enter. And you will be moved to the next line. And next, we have the approval status with the checkbox. So once this content is approved, you can click the checkbox to indicate that this content has already been approved by the client. So if you already prepare 7 days or 14 days or even 30 days worth of content using this planner, you can share it directly with your client, and then they can approve the content altogether. If they have any comments, they may also write down it in the notes section below for your reference, which makes the communication really easy. For this planner, I designed it in a way that you can reuse the same content for up to 5 social media platforms. By default, I have selected 3 of the popular platforms. So how you're going to use it is that after you have posted to that platform, say for example Instagram and Pinterest, then you're going to check that checkbox and indicate that you have already posted to that. So later on in this video, we will cover how you can change the platforms listed here and include up to 5 platforms. So now is the time we learn how to further customize this planner. On top, we have a section for you to change the header labels. For example, for monthly, we can change the monthly goals to maybe important goals. Then it will get updated in all your monthly planners. So this will save your time, so you don't have to change every page one by one in case you want to change the header title. So just want to clarify here, for the monthly, it refers to the monthly template, the left-hand side, pen. And for the daily, it refers to the scrolling calendar part. So this would include the content info, caption, the approved, notes and repurposed tool. So all this will be customizable via this table. And next we'll move on to content info. All this will controls our content info section here, so you can change all the titles here all in once using that setting page. So now I have just customized the title subtopics to others, just for an example, and you can see all the values are being updated in our planner. Moving on, I would like to talk about how you can customize the progress bar and status. In this box, you can actually key in the progress in percentages and the corresponding statuses. So this progress percentages will control our status bar. You can reduce the number of milestones you want to have, or you can add more as you wish. As for the progress bar, we can customize the color via this hex code. So for example, if I want to change the color from green to this color, brick red, I can just come here, click on this color icon, and then I'm going to come here, click on the plus icon, and I will get this hex code. Just copy, Control C or Command C, or you can right click and select copy and then click cancel. Now I'm going to come here and paste the value. So if I go back to the monthly planner, you can see that the color is now updated to the red color. Moving on, for this content info section, we have all the drop downs here. So all these are actually customizable via the boxes here. So for the content pillar, you can insert your own content pillar here. And if you want to remove it, just hit backspace or delete button on your keyboard. And for subtopics, if you want to change it to something else, you can just do it as maybe I want to insert Google Sheets. And if I go back to my planner, I can select Google Sheets from the dropdown. Then for the goals and CTA, you can add more, or you can even change the current values to maybe, if you don't want to write as follow, you want to do as subscribe, you can also do that. So all this will be reflected in all the calendars that you have here. Last but not least, for the repurpose section, if you want to add more, you can just go to the settings page and just tick on this. So here we have up to 5 that you can add to the planner. But let's say if you don't need the Twitter one, you will need some other platforms like maybe Snapchat, you can just change a value and tick it here. So it will be displayed over here for all the days. Before we end, if you want to customize the color of this planner, if you don't like this color, you can go to the theme. For example, let me show you. Go to the format and click theme. Here, click customize, or you can choose any theme down here, but I will just go to customize so you get the maximum flexibility. So to change a color, you can just come here and click plus. You can move the cursor to select the color that you want, or if you know your brand colors in your hex code, you can just enter the hex code over here. So let's say if I choose a darker color like near to black, once I selected that color, I can click OK. And you will see all these colors would be changed instantly to that color that I've just selected. So if you continue to do the rest for other columns, for example, if I change this to green, and you will see the changes being updated. One thing that you cannot change via this theme is the line colors. So I'll come to monthly template to change the line colors manually. So what I will do is to press down the command key and select all the cells at the right side of this day. I'm going to choose the first day, so later it's easier to copy to the other cells. Alright, then we're going to select a color from here. Let's say you wanted a gray color, for example. And then you can click right border. So you can see it's all being updated. So once that is done, just select the entire cell from J to L. So to do that, you have to click on the first column, which is column J. And then press the shift key and hit and click on the column L. After that, just scroll down and you'll see this square thing here. So what we're going to do is to drag from this square to the most right. So you can let go until you reach the last column. Now you can see all the lines has been updated in this planner. And if this is the format that you want for your monthly calendar, then you can leave it as it is. So you'll notice that I actually making the changes in the monthly template instead of other tabs. The reason is because that if we do it in the monthly template, we can actually generate a new one that has the same format. One thing that I forgot to mention is that you can also change the image on top to something you like. Maybe it will be some quotes or your logo. Thank you so much for listening and watching the demo. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to me at my Instagram or at my website. And I'll see you next time. Bye bye. These templates come in three different colors. We have ocean blue, softy pink, and earthy green. So if you like any of these, feel free to browse my store.